One of the biggest problems a lot of beginners to the no content and low content book publishing business have is that there is a lot of software out there. And this is software to do things like niche research, keyword research, create book covers and create book interiors. And it can be very confusing knowing where to start. So in this video, I'm going to compare three of the most common pieces of KDP cover creator software out there. And these are those all-encompassing suites that allow you to create covers, provide images, upload your own images, provide templates and that sort of thing. And the ones we're going to be looking at are the KDP Cover Creator software, which you can find in the KDP dashboard, which is free to use. We're going to be looking at Book Bolt and also looking at Canva. What we're not going to be looking at in this video are those pieces of software like Affinity Designer, Adobe Illustrator, Photoshop, and Inkscape, which are more pure image editing pieces of software. Now, they are great, and I recommend anyone who's serious about this business eventually learning how to use those pieces of software, because eventually it will give you more freedom, give you more creativity, and allow you to translate what's in your head onto the screen. Okay, we're going to be looking at these three pieces of software and looking at these main features, which is price, whether they give out KDP cover template, whether they have any free images, can you upload your own images, font selection, ease of use, and whether there are any other useful features. So first of all, if we look at price, now the Kindle or KDP cover creator tool is absolutely free, which you find within the, as I said, the KDP dashboard. When it comes to Canva, there is a free version and there is the paid version. Now, the paid version is $12.99. That's US dollars. I've got it here in Australian dollars because I'm in Australia. Now, all the tutorials I show on this channel are using the free version. And the paid version just gives you more images, more features, more storage space. But basically, to create book covers, you can do this in the free version. Then we come on to Book Bolt, and there are two versions. One is the $9.99 per month. Again, this is US dollars. And the other is $19.99 per month. The only difference is that the pro subscription for $19.99 per month just gives you access to their puzzle creation software. So we're going to take the $9.99 version, which is what you need to create covers. So in giving these a score, I'm going to give the KDP Cover Creator 3 because it's free, Book Bolt 1 point, and Canva again 3 points because it's free. Next we come on to the KDP Cover Template, and what this is does this piece of software provide you with the cover template that you need to create your cover? So we'll take a look at the KDP Cover Creator first. Now, to access this in the KDP dashboard, when it comes to the section where you can upload a book cover, you just click on Launch Cover Creator, then click on Continue. We'll have an image from the gallery that KDP provides. We'll just choose something very basic, earth tone cover. We'll go for this green cover and we'll click on Use This Image. And then it gives you a choice of cover images that you can use. We'll just choose this design. So this gives you a free template. You can see here, it gives you the section for the spine and the section for the front cover, section for the back cover, and the areas around the edge, which is the trim. If we go over to Book Bolt, this is the area where you create your cover. Now they've got this new Book Bolt Studio, which you can access by clicking on this button at the top right here, and that will take you to the Book Bolt Studio. So here you put in what your book is, a paperback. We're just going to call this test. Got the size, black and white interior, and we'll put the page count at 120. It's going to be a bleed book. We'll just pretend we're making a lined notebook and we'll hit create project and we'll see what it gives us. And so you can see, this gives us the template. Again, the area for the spine, front cover, back cover, and the pink area, which is the sort of the bleed area for the cover. Now, when it comes to Canva, you don't get a template. So you have to download your own template. Now you can do this nowadays from the KDP help section. Again, you just put in the details of your book, download the template, then upload it to Canva, and there you have it on your page. So KDP Cover Creator, yes. Book Bolt, yes. Canva, no. So I'm gonna give those 3 points to Book Bolt and KDP Cover Creator, 1 point to Canva. Now, free images. So let's have a look at what they provide. Well, unfortunately, all you have are these basic background images that KDP provides. And if we click on Start Over, we can see that all we've got are the options of the background images from the image gallery, or you can upload your own from your computer. So when you look at these images, they are very basic, they are very generic, and they are the sort of images you might find on stock photo websites. Now, when we go to the Book Bolt Studio, we've got these options here in the left-hand side menu, and we've got all these options for different shapes. So you can cover your background by putting in a rectangle shape, dragging that down to fill the cover, and then you've got these other additional shapes that you can place on your cover. So again, very basic shapes. If you want images, you do have the option of uploading your own images, or you've got these options here of looking and searching for images on Pixabay or Unsplash. I've always suggested with those sites, if you do use them, you do have to check that you do in fact have the copyright by doing reverse image searches on Google. Here I've uploaded an image of a cat just to try it out. So again, the images are pretty basic, the shapes are basic, you can upload your own images, and you can have access to images off Unsplash or Pixabay. On Canva, however, you do have a lot more images to choose from. First of all, you've got different backgrounds, so you can just pick, for instance, say, paper-like background. We'll just remove our template. Then you've got access to elements, and these can be photograph type images, these can be drawn images, and you do have a huge range here to choose from. If we click on graphics and see all, you can see here that we've got all these options. Now, a lot of these are available in the free account. Some of them you do need the pro account to access. But on the whole, you do have a lot of selection, and you can do things like edit images by adding effects, changing the colors, and of course, you can upload your own images as well. So when it comes to the features, we've got KDP Cover Creator, yes, very generic and limited. Book Bolt, shapes, plus images from Pixabay and Unsplash, and Canva, yes, a good selection. So I'm gonna give KDP Cover Creator 1 point, Book Bolt 2 points, Canva 3 points. Can you upload your own images? Well, we've just looked at that. Yes, for KDP Cover Creator. However, it is only for the backgrounds. Book Bolt, yes, and Canva, yes. So I'm gonna give all these three purely for the fact that you can upload your own images, even though with KDP Cover Creator, it is just for the backgrounds. Now, when it comes to font selection, KDP Cover Creator does have a selection of different fonts, but it is very, very limited. But it does provide ideas for combinations of fonts. So you can click on a particular font and it will change all the related fonts as well to match that particular font, which is quite useful in a way. But the number of fonts is very limited and you can't upload your own. Book Bolt Studio, we hit the text option, we have a large selection of font choices. If we hit the font menu button, we can scroll down and see the range that we do have. And you can also upload your own font. When it comes to Canva, if we hit the text button, and again, we've got all these different fonts here and sort of quite decorative fonts as well, the sort of display type fonts. We've got a huge selection that you can choose from. And also, you've got the drop-down menu where you've got a lot of the more regular type fonts, but there is a very large selection here and easy to access. So when it comes to font selection, we've got KDP Cover Creator Limited, and we're gonna give that 1 point. We've got Book Bolt, good, and you can upload your own. We're gonna give that 2 points. And we've got Canva, a very good selection, and you can also upload your own. So we're gonna give that 3 points. Now, when it comes to ease of use, I found that the KDP Cover Creator was quite clunky. You know, making your own changes was a bit difficult. The changes were limited. Things didn't always quite work as you wanted to. Book Bolt, I'd say that was moderate. Things weren't as intuitive. And one of the things that did slightly annoy me was that every time you made a change, you got the little wait screen, which will pop up in a second, like that, which again, I find a little bit annoying, and I find it slightly difficult to use. However, I think if you were to use this regularly, you'd probably get used to all of that. Canva, maybe because I've used this more, I found very easy, very intuitive. You just got these menus down here on the left-hand side for uploads, text, elements, backgrounds, and these basic drop-down menus that you do find in a lot of pieces of image editing software. And I just found this a lot more easier to use, and you didn't get that annoying little upload waiting type thing happening, that little symbol appearing. So score wise, I'm going to give KDP Cover Creator 1 point, BookBolt 2 points, and Canva 3 points. Now, when it comes to other features, KDP Cover Creator, there were no other features. It's purely designed for creating covers. When it comes to Canva, I've said no, there were no other features. And these are features in terms of creating KDP books. You can create your own interiors from scratch on Canva, but I didn't consider this as a feature. However, with BookBolt, you do have a host of other features which you get with this subscription. One is currently they're doing a weekly webinar, which is quite useful. And you also get these features on the left-hand side, which are very useful for doing research on your book. So you can do keyword research. So here you can do things like put in your keyword and get various metrics on your keywords. I don't think it's as good as something like Helium 10 or Publisher Rocket. However, it is useful and it's good in that it comes in the overall package. One of the best features I find though is this cloud function, which I use quite frequently for researching niches. So things like you can look at the top 100 notebooks. You can also look at the top 100 journals, music sheets, calendars, planners, coloring books, activity books, puzzle books, all different types of books. And when you hit search, it will rank these books in order of bestsellers rank. And I regularly scroll through this to see if there are any new books, new niches that are coming up on this list that I haven't thought of. And also it's very useful to see what's trending. So overall, when it comes to other features, KDP Cover Creator gets 1 point, BookBolt 3 points, Canva 1 point. So when it comes to the totals, we've got KDP Cover Creator on 13 points, BookBolt on 16 points, and Canva coming in as the winner on 17 points. So what are my recommendations? Well, here I've put avoid KDP Cover Creator. Now I'd avoid it unless you're an absolute beginner just looking to try KDP out and create your first book, because what you do create is very basic and very generic. So if you're serious about the business, I'd probably, you know, give it a go maybe just to create one, but avoid it as a regular cover creator. Now, Canva is excellent for creating covers and creating your own interiors from scratch, and it's free. But BookBolt, I would advise if not only do you want to create covers, but you want other features like keyword research, KDP Spy, doing niche research, and also they do have a lot of interiors there as well, which you can use and can modify. And if you upgrade to the $19.99 a month, you can also have the Puzzle Creator software, which I'm going to do a review on soon, which is actually a really good, excellent feature. So if you're looking for something free, I'd use Canva. If you're looking for something with more features, then look at BookBolt as an overall package. Now, if you are new to this whole KDP publishing business and have not yet created your first book, then I recommend watching this video next, where I run through the whole process of creating your first book, which is actually on Canva. Thank you very much for your time. It is very much appreciated. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, and until next time, and goodbye.